And the soloists, of course, were the famous Jimmy Rushing soloists with Joe Thomas, tenor saxophone, Trummy Young's trombone. Teddy Buckner was the alto soloist. And who else did we hear from? Oh, and Paul Webster's trumpet. It was High Spook, Gerald Wilson's earliest contribution to the book, and recorded August 26th of 1941. You're listening to Jazz from Chicago Public Radio. I'm Dick Buckley, and we do this sort of thing every Sunday, listening to some of the big bands that played jazz, listening to some of the giants of jazz, the good old good ones. We have coming up next Woody Herman with the first Herman Heard, the band that played, did all the things like Father's Mustache and Bijou and Blowing Up a Storm and things like that. This one featured the great Bill Harris. This was recorded at Carnegie Hall. Bill Harris featured playing Everywhere. Bill Harris featured with the Woody Herman Band at their Carnegie Hall concert. Bill Harris, who, the brief period that the first Heard was famous, Bill Harris became a pole winner, one of the most important trombone players in jazz. And then when Woody broke up the band, Bill came back with Woody. He did everything, including being a jazz disc jockey. But he never again achieved the fame or the reputation that he did when he was playing with the First Herd. Always one of my favorite trombonists. He had the guts that so many of them don't have. Next up, we have the Clayton Hamilton Jazz Orchestra. The Clayton brothers and their drummer. I'll never forget what's his name. Anyway, he was co-leader with the band, and my memory is playing tricks on me today. Jeff Clayton? Yes, Jeff Hamilton and Jeff Clayton were the co-leaders. And this is Johnny Hodges' composition that he recorded with an Ellington unit that became a favorite of musicians. People don't know it too well. You'll know it better after this. Features most of the soloists with the band. Ricky Woodard, one of the busy studio players, was the tenor soloist. George Bohannon, the trombone soloist. Clay Jenkins, trumpet. Gilbert Castellanos was the upper register trumpet. Jeff Hamilton was the drummer and co-leader, of course. This is Squatty Roo. The Benny Goodman Band at the height of its popularity, and Mary Lou Williams' contribution to the book called Roll 'Em. Mary Lou came along with the boogie. She long preceded the boogie-woogie craze when it became popular, but she wrote a lot of good arrangements. That one included a boogie-woogie chorus by the piano player. But Jess Stacy was the piano player with the Goodman Band, and Jess, he played one chorus that was close to boogie-woogie, and then he took two more in his Jess Stacy style, which I thought was more interesting. And Harry James, of course, was the trumpet soloist. I don't know who the first band was to record Clap Hands, Here Comes Charlie, but the Basie Band did it, featuring Lester Young, and so that kind of surpassed all the rest of them. Jimmy Mundy did this arrangement with Prez out front. That was the Count Basie Band with Clap Hands, Here Comes Charlie, featuring, with the exception of Earl Warren's quick eight bars at the beginning, featured Lester Young all the way. There were several bands that recorded that. I don't know who the first one was, maybe Basie, but I don't know why they picked that old tune that was a graybeard when they recorded it. Of course, it sounded good. Prez swinging away. Let's listen now to Bunny Berrigan and his orchestra. Who was it, the piano player with the band? Who said the band was like a bunch of bad little boys. Bunny was not cut out to be a leader. And of course, he's fought the battle of alcohol and lost. And I think one of the last times I said that, I got a letter from somebody saying that we should mention that a lot of people who fought the battle of alcohol won. And yes, certainly. But Bunny wasn't that fortunate. This is from November 22nd of 1938, the Bunny Berrigan Band, Gus Bavona. Yes, Virginia, there was a Gus Bavona. That name fascinated Steve Allen. And he used it in lots of his skits. fellow by the name of Gus Bellona, clarinet player. Georgie Auld was the tenor saxophone soloist, and Joe Bushkin was the piano soloist, and there was a young, enthusiastic drummer by the name of Buddy Rich. Here's the Berrigan Band with the Sobbin' Blues. Berrigan and his orchestra was the Sobbin' Blues from 1938. The tenor soloist was Georgie Auld, and the clarinet soloist was Gus Bavona. And Buddy Rich, who was such a push-push, hard-driving drummer, driving him through that one. A young, very young, almost teenager, Buddy Rich. Well, that pretty well takes care of our first hour, but don't go away because we have a lot more. I've got a big stack of records to work my way through here. That's not really right. Work my way through. No, to play my way through. I'm Dick Buckley. This is Chicago Public Radio.
How a Tobacco.
Come up next. A couple of albums that they did for the Capitol label that have been out of print for years. And finally, the Collector's Choice label put both of them out on one CD so that Jazz Ultimate with Hackett and Teagarden and Coast Concert with Hackett and Teagarden are both available on the same CD. They really did us a great favor. We're going to listen to the small band side, kind of in the Condon tradition. The only thing is they have Billy Bauer here on guitar instead of Eddie Condon. Bobby Hackett and his cornet, Jack Teagarden trombone, Peanuts Hucko, playing clarinet and tenor saxophone, and Ernie Caceres playing clarinet and alto saxophone. Buzzy Druten is the drummer. Jack Lesberg, the bassist. Gene Schroeder is the pianist. And this is Strutting with Some Barbecue. Strutting with Some Barbecue from the Capitol album Coast Concert with Bobby Hackett and Jack Teagarden, and also the other trombone. The first trombone chorus was Jack Teagarden. The second trombone chorus was Abe Lincoln. And you don't get much better than that. Let's listen now to Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars, and one of the sides that was recorded back in the mid-1950s when Louis was re-recording some of his trend-setting recordings of the 1920s. This one, the Hot Five, was recorded originally, and this particular recording was January 23rd, 1957, where they didn't attempt to play the same. They brought it up to date. The All-Stars included Trummy Young, trombone, Edmund Hall, clarinet, George Barnes, guitar, Billy Kyle, the pianist, Squire Gerst, the bassist, and Barrett Deems, the drummer. And what arranging was to be done was done by Bobby Haggard. Louis and the All-Stars, and the original of this was Louis at Earl Hines, and Two Deuces. Thank you. Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars and Two Deuces. Louis playing, he never used anything but a straight mute. And fortunately, as far as I'm concerned, he didn't do that too often. Because you know how I feel about muted trumpets. I love the brass, proud sound of good trumpet players. And when they put a mute in there, it kind of changes the sound. But Louis knew that, and he never changed it too much, just a straight mute. It was a plastic mute, so you, when you look at it, you didn't see it. But you could hear it. Here's Illinois Jacquette and a Verve album of reissues called The Best of the Verve Years. This was an interesting session that took place for Norman Granz December 13th of 1954. And the composer here is Jean-Baptiste Illinois Jacquet. Pardon my French. I guess that's Cajun, isn't it? From the New Orleans area. Ben Webster is the tenor saxophonist here along with Illinois. Johnny Acia is the pianist. Al Luke is the bassist. And O.C. Johnson, the drummer. And a conga drum with Chano Pozo. December 13th of 1954. This is called The Kid and the Brute. Thank you. Jack Cutt and Ben Webster having at each other there with the two tenors. That was called The Kid and the Brute. Reissued in Prestige, a Verve album called The Best of the Verve Years. You're listening to Jazz from Chicago Public Radio. I'm Dick Buckley, and every Sunday we do this sort of thing. Hope you're there regularly listening and enjoying. From 12 until 3. So we've got a fur piece to go. The Prestige Company is doing a lot of reissuing. This album is called All-Star Jam Sessions. They used to have so many blowing sessions. They get the guys in and somebody would dream up a head chorus, and then they'd go from there for maybe 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes. This one, Mel Waldron dreamed up the little riff and did what arranging was to be done. They decided to call it Touché. Thad Jones is here with his trumpet, Frank West playing flute, Teddy Charles at the vibes, Mel Waldron the pianist, Doug Watkins bass, and Elvin Jones the drummer. From February 16th of 1957, this is Touché. It's called Smog Bound. Thank you. James in the orchestra, and that was Smogbound. Hub Atwood did the writing and arranging for the James Band. Lead trumpet there, by the way, was Conrad Gazzo. It was a studio for the, well, actually a mixture of regular James musicians plus a couple of studio musicians, including Conrad Gazzo. Here's an album I get back to every once in a while. One of the trumpet players that I keep raving about, I don't think anyone knows who he is except me, and maybe those of you who listen regularly, Don Fagerquist, who was one of the giants of jazz trumpet, but he just got lost in the studios. He was so busy, he might probably had a cot in the studios, and he was just on so many records, it was unbelievable. Plus, he was with the Paul Weston Band on a couple of radio broadcasts. The George Gobel Show, the sign-off theme on the George Gobel Show, as a comedy show, the time varied. And when they had a little time to kill, they played the final theme. Fagerquist would play a chorus or two. I always look forward to hearing those out choruses by Donald. The album that he did under his own name is called 8x8. It has been reissued on the VSOP label, and it featured West Coast studio players, Herbie Geller, alto saxophone, Ronnie Lang, who played alto with the James Band, plays baritone here, Ed Leddy playing the lead trumpet, Bobbin of Olson's valve trombone. They had a French horn, too, Vince LaRosa. Marty Pates did the writing and arranging and played the piano. Buddy Clark was the bassist, and who else? Mel Lewis, the great swinger, is the drummer. Donnie Fagerquist and Time After Time.